Good morning, class. This morning we shall be discussing organic chemistry 2, and we shall be dealing with the aspect of chemistry of amine. But before we go into details into chemistry of amine, I also want us to understand what organic chemistry is all about. Organic chemistry has to do with the study of structure, properties, composition, reactions, and preparation of carbon-containing compounds, which includes not only the hydrocarbons, but also compounds with any number of other elements. In this course, we shall be giving out the definition of amines, types of amine. We have the primary, secondary, and tertiary amine, and sometimes we have the quaternary amine. We shall also going to talk about their reactions, how amines react to form a simple and complex compound. We are also going to discuss the laboratory preparation of amines and also the industrial preparation. I hope in the next few weeks we enjoy more of chemistry of amines in English. Thank you. We are going to discuss chemistry of amines. But before we continue the class, there are various examples that we need to know in order to understand what we are about to discuss. Objective 1 is to understand the structural relation between amines and ammonia, to discuss the methods of preparation of primary amines, to identify the various uses of amines, to explain the chemical reactions of primary amines as well as Hofmann's and acylation reaction, and lastly to use chiral arrows to show the reactions of an amine ion. By the way of introduction, organic chemistry is a chemistry that involves the scientific study of structure, properties, and reactions of organic compounds and organic materials. You could also refer organic chemistry to the study of composition and preparation of carbon-containing compounds, which include not only the hydrocarbons but also compounds with any number of other elements. Example, you have nitrogen and so on. Chemistry of amine. What is amine? Amine is an organic derivative of ammonia in which one, two, or all the three hydrogens of ammonia are replaced by an organic group or alkyl group. Compounds having RnH2 are called the primary amines. Compounds having the general formula of R2NH are called the secondary amine. And compounds with R3N are the tertiary amine. And sometimes I said you could also have the quaternary amine, where you have your R to be 4, then your N having an anion plus on top. Amines are organized into four subcategories, which include the primary, secondary, tertiary, and cyclic amines. Nomenclature of amines. If you're talking about nomenclature, you talk about the naming of amines, how any amines are named. We have several systems of naming amines, and they include the IUPAC nomenclature system, which have been approved by the IUPAC and is represented here. For example, you have the first name to be methanamide, having an alkyl compound with NH2, that's amine. The second one is propanamide, having 3 carbons and 8 hydrogen with an attachment of an amine group. The third is 2-pentamine, pentanamide, having the compound being this. We also consider secondary and tertiary amines, having the prefix N-alkyl, which is added to the name of the parent compound. Example, the first example you see here, that's methyl ethanamide, is an example of a secondary amines, while the second one, having dimethyl methanamide, is an example of amine. Classification amine. Like I said earlier, that amine can be classified into different types. We have the primary amine, we have the secondary amine, we have the tertiary, and sometimes we have the quaternary amine. The primary amine are represented when one of the three hydrogen atoms in ammonia is replaced by an alkyl or an aromatic compound. Example of primary alkyl amine is methylamine, having CH3NH2. An example of a primary aromatic amine also includes aniline,
having an NH group with a ring structure attaching to the NH group. The secondary amine have two organic substituents, alkyl group, they could be aryl group, bound together with one hydrogen. An example is methyl ethanolamide, while an example of an aromatic compound is diphenylamide. The tertiary amine is represented when all the three hydrogen atoms are replaced by an organic substituent or an organic group, alkyl group. Example, you have the trimethylamide or triphenylamide. You also have cyclic aromatic. When you talk about cyclic amine are either secondary or tertiary amine. And if you are talking about cyclic, you talk about something in a ring form or in a circle. So cyclic, an example of a cyclic amine include the three member ring aziridine and six member ring pyrimidine. An example of it is methyl pyrimidine and phenyl pyrimidine as an example of cyclic amines. Then we talk also go into the reactions of amine. As I talked about the classification, we have the reactions also. I said amines have various ways, the chemical ways by which they react to form into simple or complex compound. The first, I'm going to talk about few of the reaction, then in our next class, we continue more on the reactions. The first reaction is, amines react with acid chloride and acid detergent. The primary or secondary amine reacts with an acid chloride and acid detergent to form an amide. For example, you have methylamide reacting with acetyl chloride to form methyl acetamide. As you can see from the equation below, we have an example of a primary amine, that's methyl amine, reacting with acetyl chloride to form anamide, that's methyl acetamide. The second reactions of amine is salt formation. Amines can react with an acid to form a salt. For example, like ammonia, the amines form crystalline salts, of which the chlorides are most frequently met. As an illustration, if a few cm cube of methylamine solution is reacted with dilute hydrochloric acid and the mixture is evaporated off to dryness by steam heat, a white solid will remain, forming a salt. For example, you have a primary amine, that's methylamine, reacting with acid chloride to give you a salt. In conclusion, in today's class, we have discussed the concept of chemistry of amine, the nomenclature of amine, the classification of amine, and chemical reactions of amine. In our next class, we will continue more on the reactions of amine, and we also move further to laboratory preparation and industrial preparation. Thank you.